Another situation for the culture. Was reading the DJ Booth article. Shout out to DJ Booth. Yeah, a blog out. That's not dead.
Yes.
That's still doing
that's
his thing.
That's a blog.
Right. There you go. DJ Booth wrote an opinion piece about underground hip hop and how it's actually officially dead. Because of the internet, because the internet is pretty much the mainstream, you know what I'm saying? Do you feel like underground hip hop is just dead? It's done. Like, from what, okay, what we grew up off of. What was underground, right? What was considered underground before?
Underground is you're not on the labels, you're not on the radio, you know, you're
not on BET. Unless you're on BET Uncut.
Uncut would be
the only place you can get your video played.
The only place.
Right,
it was on YouTube. Right. So that was the only place you get your video played.
MTV3.
You can get it there. Or, yeah, something like
some
that.
Some shit like that, yeah. Right.
Something like that, but even before, I think Uncut was before those.
Oh, you know? Of course, so it was before all that shit.
It started. That was right. It at first. That was the only place. And yeah, I mean, to get it, you'd have to have like, to get something underground, or if you happen to know about an artist, you know, you'd have to go on something like, these downloading shit, like Napster or something.
Right.
You'd have to go download it from there. Or you'd have to, you know, I mean,
let me tell you the most underground shit I ever did. I bought an album, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Because back when you used to just, when we would buy CDs,
mm-hmm.
okay? Yes, you can go into like FYE or some shit like that and put the little button with the headphones, you can preview the songs or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I was in fucking one of the mom and pop shops, but they didn't have no fucking headphones. You know what I'm saying? So you bought the album based off of somebody telling you, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Or you just interested in the cover, maybe the features that are listed on there.
Maybe you heard them on a feature of somebody, so that's right. Why you're like, maybe I want to buy their album. Like
right.
They're featured on some of shit, but I never heard of them, but they went hard. You know, like they had a dope verse on this CD.
Right.
So yeah, I did that with a lot of 3-6 Mafia type shit.
Like of course.
Like with their, the people that were under their label, right. That were under them.
You know how much No Limit shit I bought?
Yeah, exactly.
Before they
no
were
Limit
doing
shit too. Yeah, exactly.
Shit on TV and shit?
Those were the prime examples of, you know, kind of, you've heard them because they were on someone else's track, and then you're like, I'm going to buy their shit also, you know, and support their label, like everyone,
yeah.
Type shit. But yeah, I mean, that was like the only way you'd get underground shit is like word of mouth.
Right.
Someone told you, oh, you check this person out, you know, because
you didn't know.
And where did they hear them from?
Or like maybe they were featured on somebody else's shit at some point,
mm-hmm.
and you heard them, and you're like, I kind of like this artist. And you went, look, they had like 4 underground albums. You know what I'm saying? You had no idea it even existed. You know what I'm saying? Shit like
straight
that.
Up.
But I remember there used to be this show on MTV where they used to battle each other. Do you remember the show? It's like a freestyle battle show. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And they had like a little competition. And I remember, to be honest with you, it was actually Dame Dash. And if you won, you could have got a deal with Dame Dash. Remember they were giving out deals for freestyle battles.
Yeah,
back then.
Yeah, yeah.
They were giving out $1 million deals and shit.
Who can win this battle competition?
Jen. Right.
Deal.
Yeah,
yeah.
Poster Boy.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, right. But there was a show on MTV and they had this guy on there. And I think his name was El Gaunt.
I remember El Gaunt.
You remember El Gaunt?
I remember El Gaunt.
Okay, so he was on there and I seen his album in the store one day and I bought his album. It was actually a pretty dope album. That was probably the most underground shit I've ever did. Okay.
I remember you put me on to El Gaunt.
Did I put you on El Gaunt?
It was you to put me on to him, yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
God damn, that was a long time ago.
Yeah, yeah, it was.
Was I playing you his songs or some shit?
Around the time we probably first met and we kicked it.
I just remember a song where I never remember anything, but I remember a song of like one of the first songs where he sampled the Goodbye from fucking AOL.
Yeah, yeah.
In the song or whatever. And I remember going, damn, this shit cold as fuck. If y'all get a chance, go look up fucking El Gaunt. This is some old shit, cuz.
There's some old
references going on right here. Okay, go
people
look
are like, who?
Yeah.
And other people are like, what?
Right, right. But like, okay, so DJ Booth was trying to say that the internet is a new, I guess, mainstream. Do you believe that?
I don't believe it. I think the internet is now just the platform for underground. Now underground literally has something to put their shit out on.
But these people are doing,
they're doing big. Yeah, they're doing big.
They're doing bigger than underground rappers did.
Well, see, now it's broken down with, you know, mainstream, underground, and now there's underneath.
It's underneath the internet.
The below. Right. The upside down.
But see, even that shit has the it has the power to go viral just right up under your nose.
Yeah. You're right. It's like underground is, I guess, what is considered underground is you holding yourself back and you barely coming out here and there a little bit, you know, because it's like pretty much if you want it, you can go get it. And yeah, you're not underground anymore because everybody can get it.
Right. The people that need to get to you can get to you. Yeah. But I don't know. I don't know if I really believe that the internet is the new.
I mean,
the new underground or the new mainstream.
That's basically I want
because mainstream is still there. Trust me. Nicki Minaj is mainstream as fuck. Okay.
Fuck yeah.
Talib Kweli is not mainstream.
Not at all.
You see what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Like, there's a difference.
Big difference.
A big fucking difference. Yeah. So I don't know what DJ Booth is talking about. I don't know if I necessarily agree with what they're saying.
I believe there's still an underground. It's just, and I believe it's just not, it's not the same. I mean, the internet changed the game, you know. I mean, you don't need labels anymore. So, I mean, but I still consider if you're not mainstream on the radio, that you're pretty much still underground to me.
Because if you're not on the radio.
I mean, I don't even listen to the radio. No, but
I listen to the radio sometimes.
Yeah,
I mean, because I have to.
Occasionally, like, you hear something. I mean, right. You hear the radio occasionally. You're riding someone else's car and they're listening to the radio.
Right.
I mean, you hear the radio, so. But.
Like, 2 Chainz is mainstream to me.
Yeah, that's mainstream.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Migos is mainstream now.
Migos is definitely hella mainstream right now. I'm trying to think of somebody Drake is hella mainstream. Kendrick is mainstream as fuck right
Kendrick's
now.
Kendrick's mainstream. You know what I'm saying?
Boss.
Big Sean.
From Dreamville, he's not mainstream.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
But Big Sean is.
Big Sean is definitely, that's what I'm saying, like, I just don't know if I agree with everything DJ Booth is saying.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I get it, they're trying to kill the underground hip hop, like, if it's a free world now, it's like, no, not really, because people out here still struggle.
Hell
yeah.
Not everyone makes it. Not everyone even makes it to the level where they're comfortable and they can just do it as a job.
Right.
And just pay the bills. You know what I'm saying? Not live flashy, but just pay the bills.
Right.
Not everyone gets that. Right. You know, there's a lot of people that don't even get that.
Right.
So, I mean, it's still underground to me.
It's underground. It's definitely a struggle.
It's a struggle.
Right.
So, yeah. I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know what you're talking about either, DJ Booth.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about?